Welcome back, my friends, to another episode of this Let's Play of Dominions 5. In this series, we are playing Middle-Age Tianxi. Let's continue from where we left off. We have a quick roundup of our provinces. We have four plus our province, our capital province, and we are still expanding. We don't for now, we are unable to see any kind of opposing nations, so we are using our scout to scout ahead and see if we can somehow see who are our first nations that we will get in contact with. So we'll see right in, over here if you see some kind of enemy nation, but for now, not yet. So that's nice. Let's keep it like that, and let's continue expanding. We probably will keep expanding over here, at least a little bit more. Let me just move out. What I should be doing, I was deciding where to build my first fort. And probably this province is going to be a nice one, right over here. It can be a nice province. So I'm going to recruit an indie commander, and his job is going to build our second fort, or first fort outside the capital. Right now, army-wise, we have this army here. We don't have a big melee line. Our main contact line from our army. We have nice set of archers, but we need a nice front line to soak up the first charge from our enemies. I don't think that these guys are going to be enough to any kind of front line combat. At least just 13 units are not enough. And the enemies are going to run through them and provoke a lot of casualties in our archers. So we'll need to wait one turn for backup before attacking this province, and it's the one that I think we should attack now. And since if they even have war elephants, we need to take a little care of that. So I'm going to move, let me show you from here, from our capital. I'm going to do something like this to our hero, and he's going to move over here, and next turn the combined armies are going to attack that province. That should be more than enough. Our first celestial master is going to site search, so that's nice. Let me just go here, do a little bit of compare with paths, one air, two water, one earth, one astral, and it can get nature or plus one on any one of that ones, right? For except earth, that's going just to be one. If I recruit an imperial alchemist, we'll get fire for sure, nature. And we can, yes, now I'm going to get one of these. They will complement each other, and we'll site search at the beginning because I really need to start getting some kind of site searching done. Sorry, my throat these last days has not been very well, so you may notice something in my voice. So that's my throat. It's not alcohol or nothing like that. It's just coughing, lot of cough. So let's hope I'll be better in the next few days. But playing Dominions 5, it's nice so that I can be a little bit distracted and enjoy myself a little bit more. For now, we have the recruitment done in our capital. We are going to need two turns for the Imperial Alchemist. We are having a nice research. We should increase this, but building a second fort, it's going to go a long way in allowing us also to have a second place where we can recruit units and build bigger armies much more faster. So that's it. Let me just check nation overview. Nothing new. This guy really needs to wait a little bit so he can patrol for just one turn. Can I recruit someone? Not yet. We don't want. Let me just check here. For my ultimate goal, what I really need is to find some kind of province that has indie mages that have death magic. In this province, I have a Jade Sorceress that can 25% of the time get death. That's really too low of a chance because normally she gets only this path. 25% of the time she will get another path, and the chance of getting death one is just 25% on that. So it's a very low chance overall of recruiting a sorceress and get my death path. Let's see if we can get some kind of other provinces where we can recruit someone that has death magic a little bit more reliably, because that's too low of a chance. And I think that's it. Let me just check magic research. We are almost, well, halfway reaching construction level level 3. And we want as soon as possible level 4 to start making all quills to boost a little bit our research. But for now, I think that's all the things that we need, that we can do this turn are done. So let's finish up the turn. No battles this turn. And nice, got a famous hero. Probably our commander and some patrolling information. And probably this is our hero. What did he got? Heroic quickness. Not really too useful, but that's okay. That's better than nothing. And that's about it. So now let me quick look up, see if I see any enemies. No, I don't. Let me just... We are going to attack this province, and let's first do the recruitment on our capital. We will have available next turn our Imperial Alchemist, and we'll keep recruiting these guys to our front lines. At least for now, I want to. I can also get some of these guys. That's nice. And that's it. Let me just get these guys that flee one battle and are lost over there and search for magic sites. We end over here. Well, I didn't even notice that I needed two turns to recruit this guy. It was some kind of mistake of my part, but that's okay. But I really wanted to start building the first level of the fort in this province this turn, but that's okay. Small mistake. Let me just do something like that and set up like this probably, and a little bit below. I'm going to try to avoid getting the elephants attacking my archers. So something like this and something like this. Probably our mage cannot cast any kind of useful spell. I don't even sleep ray. Range 1, okay, not an air shield. Only for the caster, nothing special. He can stay behind the troops. Not much he can do. At the beginning, we are researching mainly construction, so one of the drawbacks is that at the beginning we don't have any kind of useful spell. Hold and fire, closest enemy. Okay, fire closest. Since we have a full line of archers with this kind of orders, I hope they some of them can hit and can be useful attacking enemy armies that march forward. Because if for instance, if I make hold and fire archers or something like that, if they have just 3 to 4 archers, that's a lot of units that are wasting arrows. So hold and fire closest, they are spread out in the battlefield, so the closest ones that are from these guys probably aren't the same that are closest to these guys, and you can be a little bit more with more efficiency in combat. One drawback is firing closest. Probably it's the units that are fighting our main line, and normally we get a little bit of friendly fire. These guys are the ones that suffer the most with friendly fire. These ones are a little bit more shielded against arrows. So let's see if this kind of tactics works. Let's check out nation overview, research, move, search, and we have someone hiding. It's our scout. Let's move him. Let's move him. Not really. I don't really need to move him there. No really way out from that province. So, so let's keep exploring over here. Let me again check the recruitment. It's done, so I don't forget anything. You are site searching, and that's it. I don't think. Let me check. I can have Master of the Way and priests. Nothing special in this province. And I haven't showed you. I have a Wolf Tribe Shaman. Also, 10% of chances of getting a death level 1. Probably overall, it's easier to get a death with these guys than it's getting a death with these ones. Even if they are more powerful, these guys have the advantage of being cheaper. So while I recruit them, they are a little bit cheaper to try to reach the one that has net one level of death magic, so that he can use the spell to site search for death sites. But for now, let's explore a little bit, conquer more provinces, so and we still have time to decide our best approach in getting some kind of death magic before our pretender arrives. For now, we are done. Mercenaries, all of them are occupied, and let's enter. We already found the site. That's nice. Let's check our battle. 2 elephants, but they will meet these guys, so that's okay. The rest are not that complicated. Let's hope we win this without too many casualties. The elephant's already fleeing, and that's really nice. And we are almost done, just a couple of slingers, and they also flee the battle. Let's see what kind of casualties. 3 footmen, as you see. We only have 6, and 3 of them died, and I know for sure that a couple of them were with our arrows, but that's okay. Ministry, We lost three. Again, against this kind of battle, that's a nice outcome. One battle affliction, that's nice. Our hero can cure battle afflictions, and we found a site. Let's go and watch what kind of site. Mineral cave, one earth per turn, that's nice. That's really nice. First thing to check is if we see any kind of enemy nations. The longer we don't see them, the better. So another turn where without seeing them, it's nice. It's really, really nice. I'm going to join up these armies in Lu Xing, our prophet. I don't think our hero is needed in, even if he can cure afflictions. I don't think he's needed in this army. Let me just check. Our prophet is more than enough. Yeah, more than enough leadership to lead himself alone. For now, this army. So I'm bringing back our hero. Probably site searching or something like that. I think he's going to be more useful site searching than he is being in army, at least for now. That he hasn't any kind of useful spells, so he's going to move back to the to our capital, or even perhaps to this province to start also building a lab. Let's start and define the recruitment for our from our capital. So what are we going to recruit this turn? Let me just I haven't even seen what we got. Yuan Yin, to fire and to nature. That's nice. His old age, okay, probably because of these two fire, disease healer and an alchemist. Nice. He's going to also to start searching, and he can start right here. He'll move behind this guy. He's going to be over here, and let's keep recruiting our army. Let me just probably what I should be doing also. Let's lose one turn, but not now. I'm going to get some kind of priest because I don't have anyone. Bringer of Fortune. Perhaps how much is it? Two recruitment points, so it's one turn. Yeah, I should be do it. This guy's going to go to the fort, to the province where we are going to build the fort and build a temple there. So I'm going. And since he brings good fortune, that's nice. Let me keep recruiting these guys. And that's it. For now, you are going to construct building the palisades, our first level of the fort. And let me let me move. Oops, wrong. I was really seeing this the wrong way, and it's like this. Two units, I can give something like that, and you line formation in the middle, and both of you again a line formation right like that. And that's old and attack closest, old and fire closest enemies. That's it. Words of power. And Zakai Ko, I think. Ku. Ho Azian Ku is going to, since he's here, let me just start site searching. I have been forgetting to leave just a couple of province defense. Here I'm going to give a little bit more, since we are building our fort there. We don't want any kind of bad event to destroy it. and 5-5 for now. That's okay. So Palisades site searching, and then site searching here in the lab to move to site search next turn, and I think that's it. That's it. We probably should be getting another commander sometime soon in the next couple of turns with a new army. And I think that's it for this turn. Always check nation overview. Easy way to. Well, I just was start beginning to forget my main order for this turn, that it was attack with this army. So we are going to attack this northern province. I think it's the one that's the easiest one to attack, because this one has heavy cavalries, so and 50 enemy units. We should lose a couple of we should lose more than a couple of units, and I don't think that's worth it for now, since we have easier targets. So we'll attack first this province, and we'll see about next turn. Let's keep moving down here, and now I haven't forget anything else, right? Right. Let's finish the turn. And I think we have the first report of an enemy battle. First, let's construction. We have a reached construction level of 3, no magical sites, and one of our units died. That was crippled. Let's watch the battle. Should be easy enough. Let's place it a little bit faster. They are pretty much done. Just the rushers are still attacking, but that's it. We just lost one Ministry footman. These guys are a lot better than this footman. Well, at least with the combination that we use with our archers, I think that's a better combination, because if not, these guys keep losing a lot to we keep losing a lot of these guys against friendly fire. That's it. And let me just watch our enemies fighting. We are having Shinoyama against province defense. Let's see how they fare. Think Shinoyama lost, which is very, very good for us. It's very good for us that they lost, and they lost. I think where it was here. They lost here, and we now can see. At least let me check over this side. This side I don't see anyone else. Over here we see Asphodel, Ashdod, sorry, Ashdod, and Shinoyama. And the battle that they lost was right here, which is nice. One turn delay, it's always nice. And I think that's it. No new, any new. Well, how the hell do we have this information over here? So strange. Am I missing something? How do we know? Under Camões dominion, this province is. Well, my friends, that I'm lost. Do you know why this happened? Any kind of event, random event that this province got, that it was under some kind of enemy dominion, and that enemy dominion it was mine, just for chance, just for a random chance, it was my dominion that appeared here, and with it, I know some kind of info in this province that hasn't happened to me before. So it's strange. I don't know why do I have the information about this province. Probably because I have 2 plus dominion strengths there. How that dominion got there, I don't have a clue. Probably a random event. Please let me know in the comments if I'm correct in my reasoning or not. Let's decide the movements for this turn. No new beyond these 2 nations that we know that are here, and that one over there. There are any more news regarding the map, so we are ready to move our units. Firstly, I always like to do the recruitment on our capital, so that I don't forget the recruitment for this turn. So what we need this turn, let's get a couple of more ministers of magic to increase our research. We are going to check that in just a moment. Let me get more of these guys, and now I'll split a little bit our recruitment, and or not. I think this turn I'm going to do something like this, and then, because since we are seeing our first enemies, I really need a second army starting to move, so that I can get more provinces a little bit more quick. Let's check this new province. What we have here, nothing special recruitment wise. Let me place just a couple of recruitment. We are going to move this guy over here. We are keep building the palisades over there. You are going to site search here, and you are going to search here. And I think that's it for researchers. And we have our first priest that it's going to build a temple right over there. And let me check, but for this turn, I think that's it. Nothing really that I can do. Yes, again. Where to attack this turn? I'm thinking attacking these guys, even if I lose some units doing that, because these guys are a little bit troublesome. Well, I'm going to do something like this, because I really needed to speed up a little bit our conquest of provinces. So to the water I cannot go over here. That doesn't sound me an easier province. Lots of druids, lots of foul spawns, and we'll stretch too much our borders. Let me just assure that we get all of these, because it will be easier to defend if we get concentrated in this spot and not move too far. So that's going to be my decision. Let's hope that this army can handle this battle over here. Let's check nation overview. So let's move research search. Let's move our scout. Let me see a little bit more of our enemies. And palisades in 3 turns. Move, search, sneak. And I think that's it. All done. Research, construction level 4. We'll need at this pace 8 turns, something like that. But we'll try to increase this a little bit more in the next turns. We should be able to get more mages to do our research in the following turns. Let's finish up the turn. Hope for the best in the battle. Let's watch the battle. One thing that is nice, that these guys are really poorly armored. So with enough archers, and I think we have enough, perhaps we can inflict many casualties before we reach the hand-to-hand combat. Let's hope so. Placed a little bit faster, and I think perhaps I was worrying too much about this battle because it was easier than I thought. We lost three archers and one footman. With enough archers, these kind of provinces clearly are easier to take. And we didn't find any magical sites, which is a little bit disappointing. But that's to be expected. We cannot always find magical sites. Let's see now in this turn, what news do we have in our neighboring provinces? Into the north, finally, we see who are these guys. These guys are Ulm. These guys are a really tough nation to fight. Really armored, so our arrows will get will need won't be too effective against their armor. We need to find another solutions. But for now, perhaps I don't expect to be at war with them anytime soon. So let's hope they agree with me in that and leave me alone. And to the east, let me check. These guys are getting around each other. So that is our arena here. That's okay. We'll keep an eye on these guys. And down below, no news, but we should really start checking down here to see if how close are the enemy nations from us. I think that's it. Let's start issuing the orders for this turn. I'll leave that to the next episode. I hope you are enjoying it. Doing a quick look at the map and comparing it with our previous Let's Play, this map regarding the positioning of the enemy nations, this map is going to be much more challenging. And on top of that, I have increased all the levels in the enemy nations. I played, I think, difficulty in our last Let's Play, and now it's one level up. I don't know, it's mighty, or I don't know. I think it's mighty AI. So we are going to have a nice fight on our hands. Please join me in the next episode to see how we fare in the next turns. Please leave me comments, tips, if you are following the series, on how I should tackle our enemies, how Tianxi can, for instance, fight Ulm. I'm thinking in regarding Ulm that we could go with the strategy of flaming arrows. Let me know in the comments. Probably you know much more of this game that I do, so it's always nice to speak with you and learn new ways to play the game. I'll see you in the next episode, and until then, thank you.